Hello students, this is the MNBF session 2. Before starting this session, this online session may not as effective as the offline class or face-to-face conversation in the classroom. So as soon as this COVID ends, we will solve all these problems or all those doubts which may arise in online session. Fine. So in the earlier class, we were discussing about what are multinational companies and why do they go and why do any corporation or any organization want to become multinational organizations, right? So then in the earlier session we ended up with how any organization convert its own country's currency with other nation's currency, right? So today we are going to discuss, say for example, in the last class also we have taken example, one US dollar. You must be familiar, in next few classes you will be familiar with all these currency symbols. Fine, this is the US dollar. One is equals to rupees 80.70/90. See, this is what the example we have taken in last class, it seems, last session, right? So say for example, Apple or Microsoft or Ford is also from US automobile, and Apple would like to invest in India for example 1,000 rupees, minimum 1,000 rupees it would like to invest in India, but it has dollars with them. They have dollar with them because Apple is an US company and they need rupees to invest in India. In India, if they intend to invest in India, they have to convert this dollar to rupee. So how do they convert it and where do they convert and what are the factors impacting effect on these exchange rates? Fine. So in this example, US dollar 1 is equals to rupees 70.60/80. In the earlier class, I have explained these type of quotations. This is a currency quotation. The US dollar is quoted with Indian rupees 70.60/80. It means there are two rates. Even I have explained it earlier also. This quotation, this single quotation contains two rates in it. One is rupees 70.60/70.80. This is what Apple goes to ICICI Bank or HSBC Bank asking for rupee for in conversion with US dollar. So HSBC Bank quotes this currency US dollar as $1 is equals to 70.60/80. We will decode this quotation now, right? 70.60/70.80. This type of quotation is called as two-way quotation. Most probable question in your SEM exam, briefly explain different type of quotations. Under that, this is one type of quotation, two-way quotation. Why this type of quotation is called two-way quotation? Because those quotations which contains both bid and ask price. So two-way quotation can be defined as those quotations or that quotation which contains both bid and ask price. So in this session, we will get to know what is bid and what is ask and why bid is lower than ask. Why ask is greater than bid, right? So simple way, 2 marks definition for two-way quotation. Define two-way quotation. Any type of quotation which contains both bid and ask price is called as two-way quotation. Then, what is bid and what is ask? Let me explain. So in this two-way quotation, there are two prices are involved in a single quotation. One is rupees 70.60 and another one is rupees 70.80. Since 70.60 is lower than 70.80, we can call it as bid price. 70.80 is greater than 70.60 is called ask price. Then what does this mean? In this example, earlier we have discussed Apple goes to HSBC Bank for currency conversion. Currency conversion in the sense US dollar to Indian rupee. This Apple Incorporation, US company, intends or wants to convert their own dollar with Indian rupee. That's why they went to HSBC Bank, which is located in Bangalore. For instance, HSBC is nothing but Hong Kong Shanghai Banking Corporation. They went to HSBC for conversion of dollar to Indian rupee. So HSBC Bank says, gives the quote to Apple, says, for $1, our currency quotation is rupees 70.60 / 70.80. In this example, 70.60 is lower than 70.80. That's why 70.60 is called as bid and 70.80 is ask. So that means bid is nothing but this B stands for buying price, and this S you can easily remember, B for buy, ask, S for is the selling price. So what is buying price? Who buys this? What buy from whom, and what does he sells to whom? Let me explain. There are two parties involved in this entire transaction. One is Apple and another one is HSBC Bank. You can call it as banker or market is one side, and here is an individual or maybe any company. There are two parties involved, and banker quotes that my currency quotation for rupee per US dollar is 70.60 / 70.80, right? That means if a MNC, in our instance it is Apple Incorporation from US, wants to buy Indian rupee, by selling US dollar. Right? In this particular example, Apple wants to invest in India, that too in Indian rupees. But Apple is having US dollar with them. To invest in rupee, they have to convert this dollar to rupees. To convert the rupee, they have approached a banker, maybe HSBC or ICICI, whatever it is, asking for currency conversion, dollar to rupees. So this Apple is asking banker, I have dollar, kindly convert this dollar to rupee. To convert it, they have to sell the dollar and buy the rupee. Fine. For selling, as I earlier explained, bid price is the bid price is the buying price of a banker or market. All the banks are collectively considered as market, foreign exchange market or multinational business finance market. So buying price of a banker, at what rate he buys, then ask price is selling price of maybe certain currency. Selling price of certain currency by a banker or a market. So bid for B, easy to remember, B for buy. Buying price of a banker. This bid and ask is related to banker, not to this individual. Because when this Apple intends to sell the dollar, that means sell means ask price, to sell the dollar, banker becomes the buyer. If an individual sells, this banker buys it from him. So buy is nothing but bid price, that is the buying price of this banker. Buying price of this banker is the selling price of this individual. That means, let me clear it. Buying price of a banker in this quotation, earlier we discussed, in this quotation there are two prices are involved. That's why this type of quotations are considered as two-way quotations. This two-way quotation contains both bid price and ask price. So bid price is lower than ask price. Please do remember, 70.60 is lower than 70.80. That's why 70.60 is the bid price. Bid price is nothing but buying price of a banker. At what price, at what rate this banker buys a certain currency from an individual? In this instance, in this context, this individual or Apple becomes the seller, banker becomes the buyer. So banker's buying rate is bid price, right? Banker buys the dollar. That means Apple comes to HSBC Bank for selling the dollar. Apple gives the banker or HSBC Bank $1, and this banker provides rupees 70.60 to the Apple, the multinational company, right? That means this banker buys US dollar at the rate of rupees 70.60. Right? So bid price is nothing but the buying price of a banker from an individual or a multinational company called multinational companies. Right? So in this particular quotation, 70.60 / 70.80, 70.60 is the buying price, bid price of a banker. If a banker is the buyer, individual or multinational company becomes the seller. So selling price is nothing but ask price. Please don't get confused. Bid price of a banker becomes ask price of an individual. Please do think about it. Bid means buy. Bid price is buying price of a banker or MNC. So when banker buys at the bid rate, at the same time someone must be selling it to the banker. The selling price is nothing but the ask price. That's why buying price or bid price of a banker becomes ask price of an individual or multinational company. Same way, if an individual, say for example, Infosys intends to invest in US. Infosys, an Indian company headquartered at Bangalore, and it intends to invest in US. Infosys needs dollars, but they have rupee with them because they are the Indian company. They are earning their revenue in rupees, right? So they, if they intends to invest in US, they need a US dollar for investment purpose, right? So they need dollar now. Infosys needs US dollar. Again, they approach the banker, ICICI Bank, HSBC, SBI, whatever it is, and they ask, at what rate you are selling the US dollar? See, ask price. Now, individual or Infosys becomes the buyer, banker becomes the seller. So, banker's quotation is, when banker sells foreign currency or any other currencies, he sells at ask price. 70.60/70.80, he bought a dollar at 70.60 from Apple. He sells the dollar. Now Infosys is asking for a dollar. So Infosys, he sells the same dollar to Infosys at 70.80. So straight away, he is banker or a marketer or ICICI Bank or HSBC Bank or SBI, straight away in this transaction, they are earning 0.20 paise. This, because of this transaction, they bought dollar at bid price. Bid price is buying price at 70.60, and they sold the same dollar at 70.80. someone is needed this dollar, right? Straight away, the difference between these two is the profit margin of the banker or marketer, right? This is called very important SEM exam question. This difference between selling price is nothing but ask price, and buying price is nothing but B for buy, bid price. Difference between selling price and buying price is termed as spread, right? In this instance, in this session, we have discussed what is two-way quotation. Two-way quotation is the quotation which contains both bid and ask price. So bid price is nothing but buying price, or the highest rate banker offers to an individual to buy a certain currency is called bid price, and ask price is the lowest price banker offers to buy the currency from an individual. That means the selling price of a banker is called ask price. And difference between these two is the profit margin of the banker, called spread. Is called difference between ask and bid is called spread. So the formula for spread is equals to ask price minus bid price. In this example, if the quotation contains, if the two-way quotation says rupee per US dollar is equals to rupees 71.80/71.90, the lowest price is 71.80, that is bid, highest is 71.90, that is ask. So spread will be, spread is equals to 71.90 minus 71.80, that is equals to 0.10. This is called spread. Then why ask price? The universal truth is ask price is always greater than bid price. Ask price is always greater than bid price for a banker or marketer, because it is banker or marketer never makes loss from any transaction. They do their business to earn profit, right? Any banker or any marketer do their business for earning purpose. How do they earn? By buying at lower rate and selling it, selling the same currency at higher rate. That's why higher rate will be ask price, and ask price is always greater than bid price for any banker or marketer. So spread formula is, spread is the difference between ask and bid price. So formula will be ask price minus bid price. Same way, if they ask spread percentage, formula will be ask price minus bid price divided by ask price multiplied by 100. So quotation is rupee per US dollar is rupees 71.60/71.90, then spread percentage is equals to allocate these things in this formula. Ask price is always greater is 71.90 minus bid price is lowest in the quotation, it is 71.60 divided by ask price, that is 71.90. Since they have asked the percentage, it is multiplied by 100. So your answer will be in percentage, right? So in this session, we will terminate this session by learning the spread and spread percentage. In next class, we will learn why currencies appreciate or depreciate and what are the factors affecting those things, etc. Thank you, one and all.